Hey all, welcome back. This is me, Monica Sharma, and welcome to MS Bio Academy. Or I really feel that you all are really safe at your home and you are taking care of yourself. You are using the mask, you are using the soap, and you are using the sanitizer, right? And keeping a distance from the social gathering and the crowd places, right? I hope you are following all the government policies, all the government rules against the COVID spread. So, beginning with this note, let's start today's video. And this particular video is on the one of the question which came on 2009 CSIRnet life science paper. So I am taking this particular question just to tell you the trick to solve such kind of a question. If any time in future in your exams such type of question come, how you should solve it, what is the pattern, what is the method, what is the trick to solve this thing, that I'm going to discuss in this particular video. So please stay till the end of this video to get those all those tricks which I'm going to tell you. Okay, and secondly, if you have not subscribed it, if you are the first time coming to my channel, please do subscribe my channel. There are lots of questions and there are lots of very free educational content available on my channel, and that is helpful for the students who are preparing for the CSIRnet, for GATE, for class 11, 12th, and for the other competitive examination related to the biology and biotechnology. So please do enroll for it, and it's absolutely free, so you don't have to pay for anything for this. Just you have to click on the subscribe button. So please do it, and it will be helpful for you in your education. Okay, so let's start it. So this is a question for which came in 2019 CSIRnet. It says that assuming that A, B, C, and D gene are non-linked. Okay, so first of all, I would like to tell you that what is the meaning of this non-linked word. I hope you, most of you might be knowing this, but for those who don't know what is the meaning of non-linked, let me tell you that thing. So non-linked basically means if you have a chromosome, right, you know the genes are present where? On the chromosomes, right? So let's suppose these are the two genes which are present on the chromosome, gene A and gene B. Now you can see that these genes are present very close to each other, right? So they have the tendency that they are going to inherit or they are going to pass on to their progeny in the same form, means they are going to pass on together only. A and B both will be passed together in the next progeny. Alright, so that will be called as a linked genes. Okay, because they like to stay together, they want to link together. Okay, so that's why they are called as a linked genes. Now let's take the case, the another one. This is the chromosome, and now let's suppose this A gene is present here and the B gene is present somewhere here. Okay, so they are present far away from each other, right? And let's take one more case over here. So let's suppose these are the two different chromosomes, and this A gene is present on this chromosome and B gene is present on this particular chromosome. So here also they are not related, like means they are not present very near and they are not related, they are far from each other, right? So in such conditions where the genes are present very far from each other, they have a tendency that they are going to independently assort into their respective progenies. All right, so they are not linked here. All right, they don't have the tendency to go together, but they can independently pass on to the progeny, right? So these are called as a non-linked genes. I hope you got it now, what is linked and what is non-linked genes. So easy, right? So now let's coming back to the question. So assuming that A, B, C, D gene are non-linked, the probability of the progeny being capital AA, capital BB, small c, capital D, small d, from the cross between A, this parent, I'll not read this. So this is the genotype of one of the parent and this is genotype of the second parent. Okay, so they have been crossed and they are asking that what is the probability of the progeny getting this particular genotype. All right, so this is the question which you need to solve, and there is a couple of options are mentioned here, so you have to choose which option is correct among them. So 1/32, 1/4, 3/32, or 1/16. So you have to find out the probability of the progeny with this particular genotype. Now the difficult part arises here is what?
is the number of genes. Now, if this case would have been given like this way, like AABB, okay? So, this is the offspring, okay, with the two genes only. And you can say the two allelic versions of the of two genes, okay, pair of allelic versions are present in the genotype, and they are being produced by a cross of, let's suppose, capital AA, capital BB, crossed with another parent, which is AABB. If this would have been the case, this is very easy, right? Because you know that we need to just find out the possible gametes from each parents. Just draw the Punnett square and then you can get the answer. Right? So, that is quite easy. But here the case is of the four genes. Okay? So, here comes the difficulty part. Sometimes there may be this Punnett square can go to a very long, okay, can go to some making some 16 rows and columns. So, that will be too difficult to find it out. Right? So, what we can do for this? So, there is a trick for this, but that trick I'm going to tell you later. Let's first solve this particular question with the help of a Punnett square only. Okay, so in that also, how you can find out the possible gametes, that trick also I'm going to tell you. Because this question, in this question, if you see the genotype of this particular parent, you can clearly see that the gamete possibility is with the particular combination of alleles is quite just one gamete itself, right? Because see, all are in the homozygous conditions, right? So the possible gametes which we can get is with this particular combination, right? So only one possible gamete we can get, and in this also there seems to be just difference in the two heterozygous combinations are there, so maybe very less gametes we can get, right? So first trick, I'm going to tell you how to find the number of gametes. Second trick, I'm going to tell you how you can find out the particular genotype of particular allele combination of that gamete. Third, I'm going to tell you the quick trick, okay? Or you can say for a third thing, I'll tell you about the Punnett square, all right? And fourth, I'm going to tell you the quick trick for finding out the answer for this. Okay, so there will be the four tricks you can see in this particular video lecture. So, let's do the first one first. Okay, so these are the parents. First, let's write down the genotype of the parents. So, the first parent is this. Okay, it is crossed with the another parent, which genotype is small c, capital D, right? Now, in order to find out the number of gametes, the first trick, just find out the number of gametes, how many we can get, so that we should know the idea that whether we can use this method by a Punnett square, or we have to use some other method to find it out this. Okay, so first let's find it out the number of gametes. So in order to find the number of gametes, first thing you need to look into the genotype is number of heterozygous alleles. Okay, so in this case, you can see this is homozygous because capital A, capital A is present. Capital B is a heterozygous condition. Okay, capital B, small b. Sorry, this is a heterozygous. Okay, because two combinations of the two different versions of the allelic pairs are present here. So, this is heterozygous. Again, small c is a homozygous, but look at here. This is again a heterozygous. So, we have total two heterozygous alleles are there. So, there is a formula for there. So, number of gametes from this particular parent will be 2 to the power raised to the power n, where n is the number of heterozygous alleles present. So, number of heterozygous is what? 2, right? So, n is equals to 2. So, what will be 2 to the power n is? It will be 4. So, that means from this particular parent, what we'll get? We'll get 4 possible gametes. Alright, now from this particular, since there is no heterozygous form, so that means what we are going to get? We are going to get only one gamete, one possible gamete, and its genotype is clearly seen here that we can get only from this one, only A can come, this one only capital B can come, this one only small c can come, this one only capital D can come in the gamete. So this will be the one possible gamete from this particular parent, right? This is clear. Now let's talk about this one. So first we have tricked, find it out what are the number of gametes, right? So that means here in this case we can use the Punnett square. It's quite easy because one gamete and four gametes we can easily draw the Punnett square, right? One side will draw the four and one just one gamete. So we can just easily find the combinations. Okay, so that we'll come back. First let's find it out the genotype or the of the gametes, means how the gametes contain which all alleles is being is present in all these four gametes. Okay, so let's find it out that. So the second trick, now how to find it out with all these things. So the best way is you need to first write down the homozygous one whichever is there starting from the first allelic pair. So since these are homozygous ones, so what you do is you can write one A only here. Okay, no need to write two A. Then if there is a heterozygous, you need to just divert the line. Okay, from the A, divert the line. So on one side you write the capital B, on the second side you write the small b, since these are the heterozygous combination. Then again you have a homozygous. So homozygous will go to the single line, no diversion. Okay, no diversion. No need to do like this. Just write it on small c, this side also, this side also. Now again the heterozygous form is present for D, so again the diversion through the C. Okay, so capital D, small d, in this case also do the same way, capital D, small d. Now how you can find the gametes? Just write the combinations of each of these following from the A, B, C, D. This will gives you the one particular gamete. Okay, so capital A, B, small c and D. Again, capital A, B, and now this is diverted towards this one. Okay, so till here it is same till C. So you can write capital A, capital B, small c and small d. Okay, again the same way you can go this way also. So this will form this. Okay, so this will come capital A, small b, small c, capital D. And again, this is the same, but now it is diverted towards a small d. So it is capital A, small b, small c, small d. So these are your four possible gametes, okay, which will be formed from this particular parent. Okay, this particular parent, right? And from this particular parent, we have already found it is A, this gamete will be formed. Now the third method is by means of a Punnett square. So obviously we can just draw, because since it is a very less gamete, so we can find it out by the Punnett square also. So on the one side I'm gonna write the one particular gamete, which is capital this, small a, capital B, small c and d. And on the other side I'm gonna write all those four gametes and just write down the combinations, right, in order to get the progeny genotype. So I hope you know how to do this, right? So I'm just writing down, right? So I'm just going to do the combination. Okay, so it will be capital B, capital B, small c, d, d. Okay, this will be one. Then second it will be this, c, c and d, d. Now look at our progeny genotype which we wanted. Okay, what is its probability? Look at which one has this particular genotype. Okay, so AA, BB, CC, did you know AA, BB? This is the one which has this particular genotype, right? Rest of them doesn't have. Alright, so this is the particular genotype which we wanted. So what is the probability of this progeny out of all these four upstring? This is coming 1 by out of 4. So that means the probability of this genotype of a progeny by cross of these two particular parents is 1 by 4. So this is the third method. Now comes the fourth method, okay, which will be the easiest one, which we can use it if there are more than, like if there is E allele is also there. Okay, so you can use it for that purpose. E, F, G, any particular, any number of genes might be present, you can solve it by that way. So what is that fourth method is? What you need to do is you need to individually cross these allelic pairs. Okay, so what you're gonna do, you're gonna first cross the AA with small AA of both the parents. Okay, this parent capital A, capital A, and this parent small a, small a. So what is the possibility of the progeny having this combination of the A allele और ए जीन ओके व्हाट यू विल गेट इज यू विल गेट कैपिटल ए स्मॉल ए राइट ऑल विल बी विद दिस वन ओनली नाउ सेकेंड वन इज विद द बी सो लेट्स डू फॉर द बी कैपिटल बी एंड सेकेंड पेरेंट इट इज कैपिटल बी कैपिटल बी सो हेयर वी कैन गेट वॉट one we can be crossed with this so this and one can be crossed with this so what we are getting is these two combinations are only possible right then let's look into the third one so here since both are small c so all progeny will be small c now fourth one is capital E small d and capital E small d so this is similar to the b one so here also we'll get one with the homozygous dd and one with the heterozygous dd Right, now we need to find out this particular genotype progeny. What is the probability? So let me write it down here. Okay. Now, just look into this. How many of them are having the probability of having AA is? All are with the AA, right? So I'll write it down one here. Okay, because if all, let's suppose four offsprings are formed, so out of four, all will be having this. So it will come to one. So let's write down one here. Now in the second one, I need BB, capital BB. Capital BB, how many of them are there with that? It will be one out of, how many are formed? Two. So one out of two. So one by two. Next is C. So again, it is one. Since 100%, it is CC only. Now again in this one, we are getting 1 by 2. So 1 by 2. What we need to do is we need to multiply all these probability of individual alleles, genotype, and you will get the probability of the genotype of this particular progeny. Okay. So what you will get? You will get again 1 by 4. I hope this is clear to you. This is the quite easiest method, the four methods which you can use to solve such kind of a questions if it comes. So that's it for today. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next video where I'm going to discuss some more questions like this. Okay, so stay tuned and please do subscribe. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.